Hi guys, I just wanted to share, machine's probably hit in the way, why I echoed this piece. I didn't really need to, but I had to, because when I appliqued this piece down, I did not line it up with this piece. So if you put a ruler to the two points, you can see right here. This is the actual center of the outer applique piece, and this is the center of this piece. So but if I had brought my line down to it, you would have noticed it right away. So just by adding this little echo, it helps to camouflage the fact that the point is not perfect. On this piece right here, this one actually lined up perfectly. So thankfully I started with one up here that did not line up perfectly, and I knew to put this echo in. Sometimes you have to look at all your pieces before you decide, I guess, your quilting plan, because had I started on this one, these lines would have came straight down, and I would have done a lot of ripping out to make them all equal.
just about finished quilting Dance in the Rain. All I have left are the dark sections of the outer border, which I plan on filling with feathers. But these are reverses of each other. So whatever I stitch in this one, I have to do the complete opposite on this side. So on this side, I have chalked out my feather that I plan on stitching. And in order to keep it symmetrical, what I created, I just drew on a stencil that stem. See, I'll put it down so you can see it. It lines up. I just gave myself a reference of the edge and I drew my stem. So now I'm going to cut this out so that I can chalk it exactly on this side. And then also I can reverse it so that it lands on the right spot all the way around the border. So hopefully you will see this in probably another week or so before I actually get it ready for photographs, but it will be done being quilted tomorrow. Okay guys, I've cut out my stencil. I only need to cut out part of it because it would be really flimsy if I cut out the whole thing. So I'm going to line that up and I'm just going to chalk the edge of it. Oops. Well, there's something you might not have known. I am ambidextrous. So now that I have that, I can continue drawing the edge of that spine. So another thing I should have mentioned, on my plan, I drew out all my feathers. They are not going to be stitched on that line. It's going to be close. It's more of a visual. This is pretty much what I'm stitching on. I do mark a reference line of where these feathers will come around and these feathers will nest under. That's about all the marking I normally do. This one is just for visual reference. I'll only do that once.